Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, what I got for you guys is Blogtober Day 18, guys. And we have breakfast in our menu. We have a cheese toast with bacon, spinach, eggs, mozzarella cheese, to be exact. And we have our cucumbers, we have our eggs, and our tomatoes, and our lettuce, and our ranch dressing. That's my salad, and I have a cup of green tea. And guys, today we're gonna ice in this beautiful marble cake that I got up and slaved over the stove and made for you, love squads. With that being said, guys, don't forget to smash that like. Don't forget to leave me a comment, and don't forget to subscribe if you're new to my channel, and share out my videos, guys. With that being said, guys, what you're going to need to ice in your cake, what I'm going to use, this, guys. Get you some. So we're going to ice in the cake with that, and then I'm going to cut a piece. I'm gonna slice a piece out, guys, make you guys see how the inside looks. So, with that being said, guys, don't forget to check out my links. Don't forget to check out my merch and all the jobs that I posted in my description. Alright, guys. With that being said, guys, let's jump right into this video. Hope you guys are having a lovely, productive morning. Even on Sundays and Saturdays, you can't just relax all day. Still gotta get up and eat. You still gotta smile. What makes you guys smile? Leave it in the comment. What makes you smile? And whatever it is that makes you smile, do you do it enough to keep that smile on your face? I wanna know. I'm being nosy today. I probably didn't even need that much icing, guys, so let's figure it out. Alright. Let me know in the comments, guys. What makes you smile? Bacon food. That makes me smile. Like cooking for you guys. And whatnot. Shouting you out makes me smile. You know? All those good things. Of course we know praying should makes everybody happy. You believe in God. That's not what I'm saying. That's not what I'm talking about. What literally makes you smile besides your faith? Ladies and gentlemen, besides your faith, what puts a smile on your face? Is it sex? Is it doing things with your children? I know it's something, guys, ought to be able to put a smile on your face. Because I was going to say, if it's anything that puts a smile on your face, you know what you should be doing through this troubled times that we're going through, guys, ladies and gentlemen? You should be doing that every day. Seriously, whatever it is, don't be ashamed. If you know it ain't right, why are you doing it? I'm just saying, if you're ashamed of it, why are you doing it? If that puts a smile on your face and you're ashamed to say what it is, or whatever, you don't want nobody to see you doing it, you should not be doing it. I can't believe I just can't believe that pussy small on your face. To be honest with you, like, for real, that put a smile on your face, but you ashamed to talk about it.
Wow,
that's crazy. No, we need to be comfortable with ourselves enough that whatever we do in this life, we only get one, that we should enjoy it. Seriously though. But if you're ashamed of it, to me, this is my opinion, you shouldn't even be doing it though. Like, if you're ashamed of it, are you ashamed to tell somebody, oh, da 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 da, this, that, that, you shouldn't even be doing it then. Be honest with you. You need to let that go. That sounds like some that you may get charged for, so I don't know. I'm just saying, that don't sound healthy. But anyway, guys, look, this is the way I like the ice in mine. Very lightly. Then I'm coming in and put some more sprinkles on it. But no cap though, you shouldn't even be doing it. You know you got a wife, and you out messing around or whatever. That's your conscience though, but I'm just saying, no judgment. But if that's what you're doing and that put a smile on your face, to be cheating on your wife, cheating on your husband, whatever you got going on, you know what? That's why you're ashamed to tell somebody. That's why you're ashamed to talk about it. Because you know you're wrong. You know you're wrong. And you having that person just sit up there and go through that mess, and you know you're wrong and guilty as charged. How dare you smile about some crap like that? I've seen it done, guys. I've seen it done, and I'm like, oh my God. Really? How do you sleep with yourself at night? That's the part you should be asking somebody, like, how do you sleep with yourself? You know, like, if you have a friend or somebody, relative, I don't care who it is, they all messing around, cheating on their spouse or whatnot, and you know about it, you ain't getting in their mess, because you already know later on, 2 or 3 days later, after you done told the person, guess what? They back together. They back together, and guess what? They mad at you. And you ain't do nothing but tell that person the truth. But they mad at your ass. You should have shut your mouth. You should have stayed up out of that shit, right? That being said, oh my goodness, though. Have you ever been in a situation like that? That you was close to somebody? And you know their boyfriend or their girlfriend was cheating on their head. Did you be quiet about it? Seriously though, no cap. Did you be quiet? Or did you start that shit? Did you start that mess? And was like, you know what? This is my sister. This is my cousin. This is my whatever. I ain't finna sit back and let this SNO be doing that. But isn't it how it's a shame how they come back and turn the table on you though? So you got to be careful when you're dealing with a situation like that, though. No cap, though. Got to be careful. You know what I mean? Sometimes you just got to mind your business. Because some people, they just love dogs. They love dirty dogs. They love somebody to treat them like cowards or whatever, you know? They like that. They love their dirty draws. They don't want nobody to treat them with respect and gratitude and know their worth and all that. They don't want all that. Mm-mm. That's too much going on right there. That's too much truth. You know? They want to build stuff around lies. What you lying for? You a grown woman. You a grown man. What you lying for? You doing all that lying and all that cheating and all that for nothing. The end of the day, that person you cheated on ain't gonna pay for it. that person that you cheated on that person with ain't gonna pay for it. Guess who gonna pay for it, dog? You. I'll be sitting there looking stupid. You know what I mean? So I advise you, ladies and gentlemen, clear away from all that bad vibe. That was a bad vibe, period. All day, every day. I don't like that. I don't like that type of crew, that type of gossip, that type of clique. You know what I mean? I like that stay in your lane clique. Mind your business clique. Motherfucker, if he ain't see me do it, guess what? She ain't see me do it, guess what? Shut your mouth, girl. That's why we gotta be wise in our relationships. We gotta be wise in our friendships so you don't get played and abused. You understand me? No matter how good you treat somebody, they still gonna find a way to trample over you. No matter how bad you treat somebody, they gonna still trample over you. With that being said, you know what I mean. It don't make a bit of difference. It's all about yourself, who you is, the confidence in your own self. Don't depend on nobody to make you happy. You should depend on your own self to make your own self happy. Don't you dare walk around talking about, this is my other half. I don't want no half a man. I don't want no half a woman. I want a whole motherfucker. You understand? I don't want nobody to complete me. I can complete myself. You feel me? I need somebody that's going to communicate with me. I need somebody that's going to love on me. And I love on him. And blah, blah, blah. And this and that and that and that. You know what I mean? You ain't got to be 50-50. But I'll be damned if you ain't going to be 70-30. If you less than 70-30, guess what? I'm here to tell you, brother, don't even look my way. Because I ain't got time for your all day, every day. Don't come looking my way. Look at this beautiful cake. Ain't got time for it, dog. That goes for friendships. I don't got time for that messiness. Don't come talking to me about nobody else behind their back, cause I don't want to hear that shit. You got something to say? Say it to their damn face. With that being said, guys, look at this beautiful Halloween cake. Now we about to slice up inside of it and see the magic, the true magic up in there. All right. So let's get this a cut. I have to cut this sucker up. All right. So let's give it a cut. Always take your knife and go straight down in the cake. If you want a clean cut when you put it on your plate. Like so. Alright. Go in like this. I'm into the corners, like the edges of the cake. I like the edges for some reason. That being said. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, they got your marble going on. In order to get your marble, this is how I get my marble on my cake on the inside, guys. I will mix the cake up, blend it up, blah, 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 the way it's directed to do. And then I would take some like chocolate syrup. Like the last cake I did strawberry. So this time I did chocolate. And this is a yellow cake. So what I did, I took the, after I mixed the cake up, poured it in my glass bowl to bake it. Then I took the chocolate syrup, put put some in the cake. Then I took a toothpick and swirled it around. Ladies and gentlemen, swirl it around. Swirl, 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 swirl. And that's how you get your marble effect. Okay? That being said, guys, let's check out the moisture of it. Look. See, look at the moisture of the cake. Boom. Once you can go in like that on the cake, guys, and it just like, shoo, like that, you know you have a moist cake. With that being said, and it tastes so good. It tastes so good. I'm eating a piece of cake before I eat my breakfast. Isn't that something, guys? That's making me happy right now, though, because it tastes so good. With that being said, guys, I appreciate you. About to end the video. I had enough time laughing and chatting with you guys. Alright, this is the cake we decorated together. That being said, I appreciate each and every one of you for stopping by. Coming over to see you, a sales lady boss up, had pop locking over here. And as you see, she always in the game. Always in the game. Choose not to be defeated. Okay? That being said, guys. I'm about to get greedy, eat this, and chill out for the rest of this Sunday evening. It's morning now, but I'm saying for the rest of the evening, I'm about to chill out, guys. Hope you guys do the same. Do something. Do something. I don't know, but do something. Do something nice and relaxing. All right? With that being said, guys, if nobody told you today, love squads, let me be the one to tell you. I love you, and I appreciate you, and I thank you for everything that you come over to my channel and do, guys. All your support, I appreciate it. With that being said, guys, I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace. See you guys in my next one. Bye, guys. Take a good last look. Woo! Get yourself. Ooh, look at that. That looks so scrumptious. Look at that, guys. I like to give a shout out to I Love Lunches. Guys, if you don't have I Love Lunches, make sure you go check out our channel. Like what you see, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and share her videos, guys. I appreciate you guys. I'll be leaving her link in the description. With that being said, guys, take a good last rule. Bye. Have a great day. Blessed day now. Bye.